Hello everyone. So we were in the middle of doing a reverse scenario for our brightness controlling system, right? So if this is 0 and this is 5 and this is, that means this is 0 means ground, okay? And this is A0, so any analog pin you want to go, then this is the increasing side, right? And yes, this is the decreasing side, D, because the direction which is going from 0 to 5 and 5 is to 0, 5 to 0. So 0 to 5 is the increasing side and 5 to 0 is the decreasing side. We know it, right? That means ground to 5 and 5 to ground. So let's say this is ground. This is ground, this is 5. Okay, so the direction from ground to 5 is increasing, 5 to ground is decreasing. Okay, so we don't care. That means input decreasing, okay? So we all know it, and we talked about, okay, earlier how this thing was. For the highest analog input, we have the highest analog output, okay? Only with the mapping was there, okay? Only the mapping was there. Apart from that, highest, okay? Highest input, highest output. Lowest input, lowest output, okay? Again, the mapping was there. So for the in-between values also, the respective in-between values were given. So now what we want to happen is the opposite way. Wait, so how this happened is, we had the mapping. So where we had, okay, from 0 to 1023 should go to 0 to 255. Okay, so lower one to higher one, and again here lower one to higher one. Okay, please note this guy. In this mapping, 0 to 1023 should go to 0 to 255. So this is lower, this is the lower limit of the new mapping. This is the highest lower limit of the current, highest limit of the current mapping. This is the highest limit of the new mapping, okay? So lower to higher, we know all these things, okay, fine. So now what we are supposed to do is actually, so as I said, okay, this is fine. So what I want to do is, the other way around, right? So what is the other way around? Higher should go to lower one, okay? Lower should go to higher one, okay? And also these numbers, let's think about the point one, okay? Let's say this is point one and this is point two in between values. This point one should go to here and the point two should come here, because we have to do the reverse scenario, right? The opposite way. So we, in the input, okay, we cannot change it, right? It will go from 0 to 1023. There's no way, okay? So minimum input will be 0 and maximum input will be 1023. But the output we are going to change. Earlier, for the input to output, the output also going from 0 to 255. Yes or no? For the minimum input, we had minimum output, 0. And for the maximum input, we had maximum output, 255. Now we want it to be happening the other way around. That means this way, towards like this. We have to travel from 255 to 0. We have to travel from 255 to 0. This is the new need we have, right? Still no change in the analog input, only the output. If the analog input is going 0 to 2023, we have to travel from 255 to 0. Okay, that is the only thing you have to understand. Then, yes, for the lowest inputs, we will get the highest output. And for the highest input, we will get the lowest outputs. That, in another words, if you are rotating in the increasing side, the brightness will go down. Why? The rotation is input. Output is the brightness, actually, okay? So input is increasing, output is going to go down. That means brightness is going to go down. Input is decreasing. Okay, let's say this is going down, output will be increasing. Or you can think like this: if the input is increasing, output will be decreasing. Okay, so the other way also true. Okay, so anyway, so if this scenario becomes true, if you are increasing the analog input, brightness will go down. Okay, and the other way also true: if you are decreasing the analog input, brightness will go up, obviously, because you can see, for the lower analog input values, higher outputs are given right here. If you are doing in the reverse value, okay? So I think this is understandable, right? So where we have to change the scenario is where we are playing around with these values. So for the highest analog input value, okay, earlier we had the highest analog output value. Lowest analog input value, we had the lowest analog output value. Now for the highest analog input value, we have to map the lowest analog output value. And for the highest analog, lowest analog input value, okay, this one, I mean for this one, okay, this one, we have to map the highest analog output value. Okay, so here, simply talking, the current scenario, how it happened is, we have the x, and you can remember the map function. Okay, map function will have the value, whatever the value, and the two, sorry, from low, I mean from of the current map, right? I'm sorry, low from or from low? Yeah, let's say low from low value of the from range. Okay, I'm sorry, I don't remember. Just think like this. Okay, initial range from to 2. Okay, from initial range to 2 initial range. Okay, then from final value, final range, from value of the final range to value of the final range. Okay, this is the map function's rule, right? So likewise, here we can take the example, we have the x, and the from value of the initial is 0, to value of the initial is 1023. And the from value of the initial is final range is 0, to value of the final range is 255. But now what should happen is from value of the final is, that means output ranges should become 255. Why? Because when we are starting the input from 0, we have to start the output from 255, because we are going to go in the next downward direction. Okay, so now our initial from value of this output should be 255, and the ending value of the output should be 0. For which, for this direction, analog input, right? That means analog input from 0, from value is 0, and the 2 value is 1023. But for the same, analog output should be from value is 255, and the 2 value should be 0. Okay, so what we have to do is, here we have to change, because here is the from to thing is there. Okay, so initial value, that means initial means input values are never changing, right? Because input we cannot touch, it will go from 0 to 1023. But for the same, we have to change the output direction. That's all we have to do. You understand that? So we have to start from 255 and go to 0. Okay, then if you do the mapping like this, this will work perfect, because for this range, this initial range, we will get the opposite values. Okay, so for any value that is in between this, let's say I'm taking a different color, this color, in between this range, that will work like this now, opposite way. Okay, this will go here and this will go here. Okay, and this value earlier that went here, now will not go here, go here, opposite direction. And this value earlier went here, will not go here, and will go here. If you don't understand, just don't worry, but just remember, if it goes up, this will go down. Why? Because we have changed the map direction. Which map direction? Final map direction only. That's enough. Okay, so now it should work as we expected. That means if we increase this input value, brightness should decrease. If we decrease this input value, brightness should increase. Okay, so just I think you will have a better idea rather than the first video of this same task. Now you will have a better idea, I hope. Okay, so just follow me up in the upcoming videos. We will be doing more practicals, and I will be explaining the code a little more on that, and the scenario again. Okay, so that will make you the picture much more clear. Okay, because this might be a little bit tricky to you, but if I am explaining it again and again, you will try to catch it. Okay, so and also we will do a demonstration as well and see whether it works fine or not. So just don't worry, guys, believe me, it will get better with upcoming videos. Just follow me in the next video, guys. Until then, consider subscribing us and stay safe, guys.